While the French do a healthy business in shrugs and even, when equipped, mustache whirls, they are for the most part an undemonstrative people. Yet the Ford GT's abrupt transition to its track mode, the car dropping 2 inches as hydraulic actuators compress its supplemental coil springs, the rear wing rising with an equal suddenness, is impressive enough to coax a collective sigh of appreciation from a group of Le Mans corner workers and other informed spectators watching as the car readies itself to head onto the famous circuit. Highs. Closest thing to a road-going Le Mans winner. Hugely exciting, makes rivals seem tame. Lows. Loud, crude, expensive, completely impractical. Verdict. A staggering achievement in a future classic. Although we've brought the new GT back to the site of its most celebrated racing win, the 2016 class victory taken in its first entry to the 24-hour race, this is not an exploration of what the car is capable of on the track. Our photographic use of Le Mans's short Bugatti circuit happens during the lunch break, and even though in France that equates to 2 hours, access is on the condition that we drive gently enough not to trip the noise meters.